Hello once again, everybody. Where I left off, I have found my way to the good neighbor, and now it's time.
Hold up there. First time in good neighbor?
Uh-huh.
Like walking around without insurance.
Sarcastic.
Unless it's keep dumb assholes away from me, insurance. I'm not...
I think you're gonna like what I have on offer. You hand over everything you got in their pockets, or accidents start happening to you. Big, bloody accidents.
Whoa, time out. Someone steps through the gate the first time, they're a guest. You lay off that extortion crap.
What do you care? He ain't one of us.
No love for your mayor, Finn? I said let him go.
You soft Hancock. You keep letting outsiders walk all over us. One day, there'll be a new mayor.
Come on, man. This is me we're talking about. Let me tell you something.
Oh, oh snap. Woo, give me this. There we go. You killed him.
You killed him. Got a good pair of eyes on ya. Good neighbors of the people for the people. You feel me? Everyone's welcome.
All right.
Of the people for the people? Brother.
I can tell I'm gonna like you already. Just consider this town your home away from home. So long as you remember who's in charge.
All right then. Let's see. Right, I'm done. Yeah, right, the doctor.
Brotherhood of Steel, better stay out of good neighbor. All I'm saying.
Okay then. All right. Girls. All right then.
Well, well, Mr. Valentine. I thought you had forgotten about little old me.
May have walked out of the den, Irma, but I'd never walk out on you.
Amari's downstairs, you big flirt.
Okay. Okay, what? Oh, okay. Walking in circles.
Dr. Amari?
Yes, I take it this isn't a social call.
This one's all yours, Nick.
We need a memory dig, Amari, but it's not going to be easy. The perp, Kellogg, is already cold on the floor.
Are you too mad? Putting aside the fact that you're asking me to defile a corpse, you don't realize that the memory simulators require intact, living brains to function.
Wait. So what now?
Isn't there some way to make this work?
This dead brain had inside knowledge of the Institute, Amari. The biggest scientific secret of the Commonwealth. You need this, and so do we.
Fine. I'll take a look. But no guarantees. Do you have it with you?
Here you go.
Here's what I could find.
What's this? This isn't a brain. This is... Wait, that's the hippocampus. And this thing attached to it? A neural interface?
Those circuits look awfully familiar.
I'm not surprised. From what I've seen, all Institute technology has a similar architecture.
Go on, Doctor.
Mr. Valentine is an older generation synth. But Institute technology being what it is, the brain implant could fit him. But that's an incredible risk to take. We're talking about wiring something to his brain.
Don't worry about me, Amari. I'm well past the warranty date anyway.
Will this work?
You really think this will work, Nick?
No idea. But we got a missing kid on the line. That's worth the risk.
Whenever you're ready, Mr.
Okay, then. Thank you.
If I start cackling like an old grizzled mercenary, pull me out, okay?
Let's see here. I need you to keep talking to me, Mr. Valentine. Any slight change in your cognitive functions could be dire. Are you feeling any different?
There's a lot of flashes. Static. I can't make sense of any of it, Doc.
That's what I was afraid of. The mnemonic impressions are encoded. It appears the Institute has one last failsafe. There's a lock on the memories in the implant.
Tell me you have a way past this, Doc.
Let me think. The encryption is too strong for a single mind. But what if we use two? We load both you and Mr. Valentine into the memory loungers. Run your cognitive functions in parallel. He'll act as a host, while your consciousness drives through whatever memories we can find.
Okay.
Nick and I are gonna share a mind? Yeah, I'm not gonna see him in any compromising positions, am I?
If a smart mouth was all it took to solve problems, we would have found your son by now.
No. You won't have to worry about that. The only memories you'll access are the ones in the implant.
Alright then, let's do this.
Right. Let's get started.
Just sit down over there and keep your fingers crossed.
Alright then. Alright then, see you soon. Please stand by.
Initiating brainwave migration between the transplant and the host. Mnemonic activity coming from the transplant. It's degenerated, but it's there. We're going to load you into the strongest memories we can find. They might not be stable. Just hold on.
Oh, Jesus, whiteness! Ah! A lot of whiteness! Alright then.
Can you hear me?
Yes.
The simulation appears to be working, although the memories are quite fragmentary. I'll try to step you through the intact memories and hope we find one that gives us some clue to the Institute's location.
Okay.
This is the earliest intact memory I can find.
Do I have to follow this? Okay, look, there we go.
Remember,
there we go. Whoop whoop.
These memories is Kellogg. This may prove disorienting at first.
Turn down the goddamn radio. I'm trying to sleep. California Republic.
All five states have now signed on. Is this Kellogg?
Someone else is going to keep them safe.
Teacher at school said the NCR would bring back the good old days. Like before the big war.
Don't you listen to that twaddle. I'm going to stop sending you if that's what they're teaching you.
I'm going out. Where the fuck did you put my boots?
Listen to me, Connie. You take this. You're old enough. You're the man of the family now.
What?
It's your job to protect us. Your father's.
He's just a child, man.
You will turn up like him. You're a good boy. And all that on the radio. All useless talk. The only thing that will protect you in this world is that gun in your hands. You need to learn to use it if you're going to survive.
I will, Mom. I promise. I won't let you down.
You've always been my good boy.
This doesn't seem to be what we're looking for.
Nope, it's not.
There appears to be another intact memory close to you in temporal sequence. There.
Okay, then.
Try that one.
Alright, here we are. This is Kellogg.
But we don't know anybody here. And now, with the baby?
Come on, Sarah, you've got to give it a chance. I finally got steady work with a good outfit. Nothing like that in the NCR these days.
I'm not saying this was a mistake. I'm just... Are you sure these guys know what they're doing?
The thing about happiness is, you only know you had it when it's gone. I mean, you may think to yourself that you're happy, but you don't really believe it.
Focus. Ooh, look at that.
Bullshit or next job or whatever. It's only looking back by comparison with what comes after that you really understand. That's what happiness felt like.
You seem kind of green.
I know, but that's where I come in. Just wait. In a few years, I'll be running my own crew. As soon as I make the connections I need, then I can give you anything you want. And little Mary, too.
I never worried about you before. Must be my mama instincts kicking in. Who knew I had those, huh?
Come on, you're great with her. And you don't need to worry about me. Most of it's just running security for the she. A lot of standing around looking tough.
Well, they sure picked the right person for that job.
Listen, it's gonna be great here. See this? This is what's gonna keep you and Mary safe. I promise.
I know, honey. I'm sure we're gonna be really happy here.
We are. You'll see. That's okay. I got it.
Let's keep looking. I'll connect you to the next intact memory.
Okay, then. Let's go. Whoop, whoop.
How did you think this was going to end, Kellogg?
Kellogg.
You thought you could just fuck with us, and we wouldn't fuck with you? Just so you know, they died like dogs. And you weren't there to help them.
I found another memory to try. I'll connect you.
Okay.
Mind if we sit down?
Suit yourself.
Wastelander. Ooh, that's me. Hi.
So, I hear you'll take care of people's problems. Is that right?
If you pay me. Oh, we'll pay you.
And you'll do this all by yourself.
That's right.
We pay you when the job's done. Is that okay?
That's the way you want to do it. So who do you want dead?
Well, it's like this. There's his family. Lives down the creek a ways.
Well, we seem to be getting closer. Try this.
Uh-huh. Place.
Mr. Kellogg, I'm glad you decided to meet with me.
So, you're with the Institute. I wanted to see for myself if you really existed.
We do, as you can see.
What do you want?
It's come to my attention that you've been rather disruptive of our operations lately. This must stop.
I do what people pay me to do. If that's a problem for you, I can see only one way out.
And what's that, Mr. Kellogg?
If I'm working for you, there's no more problem. From what I hear, you can afford me.
I don't think you fully understand the situation you're in.
I think I do.
Very well. B-748, initiate.
Oh, snap. Well done.
Impressive. We may have something to talk about after all.
Getting warmer. One of these has got to tell us something. We're running out of brain here. There's one that looks mostly intact. Connecting now.
Manual override initiated.
But this is fold 11.
Vault computers are still working. That's good. Checking through the logs. Hopefully it's
just
all.
Find it.
That's my wife. And that's me. Hi.
This is the one. Here.
Open it.
How do you know it's a boy?
Get the kid out of here. Let's go. At least we still have our back.
Cryogenic sequence reinitialized.
What's the holdup? I'm almost finished, Kellogg. I just need to confirm. Alright, we're good.
Go through that again.
Yeah, it was painful. Why did you do that? My wife is dead. No, never mind. All right. Yes. I hope. Sean. Oh, where did you came from?
Get your head blown off just barging in here like that.
Minimizing my exposure to civilians is a priority.
Forget I said anything. So what's the big crisis this time?
New orders for you. One of our scientists has left the Institute.
Left? As in?
He's gone rogue. Name's Dr. Brian Virgil. We know he's hiding somewhere in the glowing sea. Here's his file.
Wow. Some heads are gonna roll for this. Capture and return, or just elimination?
Elimination. He was working on a highly classified program.
No kidding. One of the top bioscience boys? Damn. So, I guess you're taking the kid back with you.
Affirmative. Your only mission is to locate and eliminate Virgil.
You're taking me home to my father?
Yes. Stand next to me and hold still.
Okay.
X688. Ready to relay with Sean.
Bye, Mr. Kellogg. I hope I see you again soon.
Oh, snap! Where did he go?
Portation. Now it all makes sense. Nobody's found the entrance to the Institute because there is no entrance. Let me pull you.
That's clever.
As soon as you're ready.
Alright, I'm ready. Alright. Okay, there we go. Ah ha ha ha! Whiteness! Again, a lot of whiteness! Ah, Jesus. Please stand by. I feel fine.
I'm okay, Doctor. Thank you.
That's good. But I want you to keep monitoring yourself. We have to be sure there's no long-term damage. Are you ready to talk about what happened in there?
I saw Kellogg's life. The man who ruined my family. The man I killed.
That's right. He was a human being just like the rest of us, and he had reasons for being what he was, however cruel. How does that make you feel?
Let's see, I don't know.
I'm not sure, Doctor.
I don't know if there's any right way to feel, either. We're getting off track. The important thing is that we discovered the Institute's greatest secret, teleportation. The only question is, what do we do now?
That scientist Kellogg was supposed to track down. Virgil, we need to find him.
You're right. A rogue Institute scientist could answer all kinds of questions. Where did the memory say he was? The glowing sea? That doesn't make sense. No one goes there. Not even if they were desperate.
I'll find him.
If we need to find Virgil, then I'm going after him.
If you're going to go, be prepared. You'll need some way to combat the radiation there. It's called the glowing sea for a reason.
How do I fight that much radiation, Doctor?
There are chemical compounds. Rad-X, Rad-Away. You'd need as much as you could carry. Maybe more. A sealed environment suit would be great, if you could find one. Or maybe one of those suits of power armor?
Oh, yes!
I'll find a way to get through the rads. Don't worry.
Good luck. And be safe. By the way, I unplugged Mr. Valentine first. Removed the implant while you were waking up. He's waiting for you upstairs.
Alright then. But first I'm gonna pause it, and I'll be back in the next video. Thanks for watching! Bye!